Трудно беше. Служих за братко в 9 клас. Имах много обиди, бях много наранено.
Islamophobia, anti-Muslim racism or anti-Muslim hatred is well present here in Bulgaria and even normalized, some Muslims say. It's felt in different segments of society, from the judiciary to education and the media.
После тръгнахме на училище. Преди да служа за братка, в правилника нямаше забрана за забратка. После го направиха правилника така. Постоянно получавах предупреждения, че нарушавам правилника за училището.
Целта им беше детето да свали забратката и да ходи на училище без забратка. Това продължи до средата на първата учебна година в 9 клас, след което и наложиха заповед, предупреждение за преместване в друго училище. След изтичане на тази заповед и наложиха преместване в друго училище. По документите преместиха в друго училище.
The family says this other school was 250 kilometers away, but the actual transfer never happened. After unsuccessful cases at local and national levels, the family appealed to the European Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg.
Това ми беше интересно, че когато тя ходеше с забратка 4 години в училище, имаше го това изречение, че се забранява влизането в училището с забратка. След което вече тя като завърши, премахнаха тази забрана, влизането в училището с забратка. И по този начин се играят с нас мюсюлманите.
Emine's case is not isolated. A few students wearing hijab were denied access to their final exams at schools, which are crucial for graduation and further education.
Islamophobia is a serious problem for the Muslim community in Bulgaria. It's a reality of everyday life. Islamophobia is deep-rooted in the Bulgarian society because of the Ottoman past of the Bulgarian state. The Muslim community and the Turks are the biggest minority in Bulgaria. That's why many politicians and public figures look to the Muslim community as a threat to Bulgarian society and Bulgarian state.
Islam came to Bulgaria in the mid-9th century through missionaries, but it mostly spread during Ottoman rule from the late 14th until the late 19th century, with many Turks settling in the country. From 1959 to 1989, the Turkish community was a target of the communist regime and subject to the assimilation policy, officially called the revival process. A name change was a huge part of it. So, Behriye Mestanova became Borislava Mladenova, and Ismet Ismailolu was renamed to Ilko Iltsev Panov. The Muslim identity faded away, and the consequences are still being felt. And many Islamophobic ideas are spreading through different channels of communication.
You cannot stop social media. This is more rough ground there. They are telling stories without checking facts, without even thinking about facts.
Islamophobia mostly reflects in the prejudice against the population and the anti-Muslim statements. Attacks on the Muslim-owned property are rare, but still happen.
Какво трябва да се направи? Ние сме сезирали органите на реда, където трябва да се сезира, но така или иначе не се намира решение на проблема. Решението е в мирното съжителство и...
Muslims now form up to 15% of this society. But according to the Pew Research Center's projections, Bulgaria might be the only European country to see a drop in their Muslim population due to people leaving the country.